Thanks to switch to D550, it is very easy to replace an analog voltage regulator R449 with the digital D550 regulator. This stands whether the R449 is equipped or not with an optional module. Switch to D550 consists of a voltage regulator D550, a set of 1 meter long made end-lock cable, an USB cable, and one installation guide. If your machine is not equipped with the optional terminal block, we recommend you to buy one. This will make commissioning much easier. Remove the panels to access the voltage regulator. Here we will replace an R449. Disconnect all fasten connectors from the regulator. Unscrew the four fixing screws of the regulator. The R449's fixing holes are the same as those of the D550, so these two regulators are mechanically interchangeable. Put the D550 in place of the R449. Connect the five made end lock connectors of the cable harness to the corresponding connectors on the D550. The made end lock connectors are foolproof to prevent connection mistakes. Now, let's look at the connection to the terminal block. In order to install the DIN rail, we remove some terminals, and they will be put back in place once the rail is installed. Install the optional terminal block in the location that suits you. This can be inside or outside the generator terminal box. Here we choose to install it on the back of the regulator holder. Screw the DIN rail and put back the terminals. Release the various cables coming from the machine. Then cut the wires with the fasten lugs. And strip them. Connect each of these wires coming from the machine to the corresponding part of the terminal block. This must be done according to the wiring diagram described on the switch to D550 manual. To operate, the D550 requires an auxiliary 1224 volts power supply, not included in our supply. This power supply must be installed between the plus and minus terminals of the terminal block on the alternator side. Now, let's take the other end of the cables connected to the D550 regulator and connect them to the other side of the terminal block. Connect the wires according to the labeling. Terminals 7, 8, 17, 18, and 37, 38 should be used if your alternator is equipped with one or three current transformers. The inputs and outputs can be connected to the last available terminals on the terminal block. Safely attach the harness to the cables inside the terminal box, using the clamps supplied in the kit to prevent it from vibrating. Reassemble and screw the lids of the machine. The D550 is programmed with the EasyReg advanced software that you can download free of charge from our website. EasyReg Advanced allows to import the regulator configuration or to modify the regulator's parameters by filling the details of your machine. Thank you. The voltage Z point or the PID are predefined according to the previously configured machine.